Hey guys, all right, so now I'm going to show you guys how to use the live paint bucket tool. It's a really cool tool. So let's go ahead and get started. So we're going to do this monkey. And oh, there's my bear. Go ahead and delete that. Again, file. Now you should have your, your presets. Okay, selected. If you guys still do not have what I'm looking for, go to print, inches, and pick one, landscape or portrait. Okay, if you've done it and you come over and look, you should have those templates in there. All right, so I'm gonna go there. Now, what you need to do is you need to go to the internet and you're gonna need to search. Okay, and what I typed in was clip art, black and white. And you can say clip art, black and white animals. You can say anything. There's all kinds of things that you can do. I would prefer that you guys try to find some type of animal or creature. All right, and pick one. So, and I can't remember where my monkey was, but I scrolled down a little bit when I found him and decided to use him, so this lion would be a good one. There's tons of different ones that you guys can use. Okay, so again, once you find it, select it, either save it from here or save it from here. Either way, that's what I'm looking for. Okay, so again, I already done so. Place, and here is my monkey. I'm gonna select it and I'm gonna hit V so I can zoom in. Okay, as you can see, he's really pixelated, okay, and I can't use him the way I want to use him, all right? So again, pictures, you need to embed the pictures. Image trace, I'm going to trace him out. Black and white logo should work just fine, and it does. Now you can see much cleaner image, okay? So the first half is done. Now I need to expand him, all right? Now he is expanded. And then from here, a couple different things that we have to do from what we've done to this point, and that is we need to go up to the object and we're going to go to live paint and we're going to make. Basically what we're doing is we're making all the objects again, all right? So that way the paint bucket can read these objects, and I'll show you what I mean. So we made him, then we got to go back and we're going to go to live paint again, and now you need to expand him again, all right? Boom. He is expanded with him selected. I believe the shape builder tool is the home tool, that shape builder tool. So if I right click and we go to live paint bucket, which is K, I now have my bucket. And here you can see that I can pick colors and I can go in and start coloring up my monkey. So I'm gonna hit the drop down. And I'm going to go to, I believe it was color history. And I think I went with like ancient tones. All right, you guys, there are so many options. Okay, but I think I did something like this. And then I can just come in here and begin to start coloring. So notice how I get this red line around the object that I'm going to color. All right, so that's what you're looking for. There it is. It is completely selected. If I come out here, that's everything. That's the stroke, the black, but I want to keep the black. So I'm going to come here. Okay. So I got that. And now you can see I'm just going to go around and pick some colors here. That object. That object. Okay, let's see here. Let's go with a light blue for his eyes, on the inside of his eyes. Let's go with a peach colored face. I'm going to give him a brooding brow. There we go. And I forgot the hands. I don't remember what color that was. So we'll go there. Okay. So something like that. As you can see, that was fairly easy. Now I'm going to hit my selection tool, and I'm going to just go check and see if I have any borders around. As you guys see, I do. So just like the other one, when we were doing the logos or the mascot, whatever the case may be, we're just going to go and remove that background like so. All right. And we're done. Simple as that. So as you guys can see, it's a pretty cool tool to use. Make sure that you guys, when you bring in that image, okay, again, that you guys are expanding it, and we're going to that object, and we're going to light paint, and then you need to make it, and then after you make it, you go back again, you go to object, you go to light paint, and you expand it once more. Okay, so I hope that makes sense. I hope you guys have fun with this. Again, pretty simple. Find an animal, find some type of creature, and color them all up. All right. All right, guys. Good luck. Peace out.